The following factors will affect the value of ionization potential or ionization energy: atomic size, effective nuclear charge, shielding or screening effect, and half filled or completely filled configuration. Let's see the details of each factors and how it affects the value of ionization potential. Important factor affecting value of ionization potential of an element is atomic radius. If atomic radius of element is high, then the value of ionization potential of that element is found to be low. That is, ionization potential is inversely proportional to atomic radius. Higher the atomic radius, ionization energy or ionization potential of that element is low. Let's take two examples: hydrogen and sodium. Hydrogen atom number 1, electronic configuration is 1. Sodium 11, 2, 8, 1. Out of hydrogen and sodium, atomic size of sodium is bigger. So the outer electron is far from the nucleus, and the force of attraction between outer electron and nucleus is less. Okay, due to the less force of attraction, removal of valence electron is easy. So what about ionization energy? Ionization energy become less because by using low amount of energy, less amount of energy, we can remove electron from sodium. Clear? So higher the atomic size, the value of ionization potential found to be low. What about hydrogen? Hydrogen compared to sodium is small. Atomic size is small. So outer electron is near to the nucleus, and the force of attraction between outer electron and nucleus is high. Due to this high force of attraction, removal of valence electron from hydrogen is too difficult. So what about ionization potential, ionization energy? Ionization energy become high because high amount of energy required to remove electron from hydrogen. Okay, so it's very clear. Small atomic radius, ionization value will increase. The next factor is effective nuclear charge. Ionization potential is directly related to effective nuclear charge. That is, effective nuclear charge increase, ionization potential of that element also will increase. We know that when effective nuclear charge increase, size of the atom will decrease. Okay, when size of the atom decrease, what about ionization potential? Ionization potential will increase. I repeat, when effective nuclear charge increase, atomic size will decrease, then ionization potential will increase. So from this point, it is clear ionization potential is directly related to effective nuclear charge. Let's take second period elements, lithium to neon. In second period, from left to right, nuclear charge and effective nuclear charge is increasing. So neon possesses high effective nuclear charge. When the effective nuclear charge is high, the size of the atom will decrease. So neon possesses high effective nuclear charge. So due to high effective nuclear charge, the size of neon is very small. Let's see the value, around 2000. Why neon possesses high ionization energy? Because due to high effective nuclear charge, size of neon is very small. When atomic size decrease, ionization energy correspondingly will increase. Lithium, compared to other elements, effective nuclear charge of lithium is less. Okay, due to less effective nuclear charge, size of lithium is high or large compared to other elements. Okay, so when the atomic size increase, What about ionized energy? Ionized energy will decrease. That is why it is 520 kilojoule per mole. Okay. So from these values, it's very clear. Effective nuclear charge increase, ionization potential value also will increase. Okay. And this value is indirectly connected with the atomic radius also. The next important factor affecting value of ionization energy of an element is screening or shielding effect of element. Let's see the two examples, lithium and sodium. In lithium, there are two inner electrons, but in sodium, 10 inner electrons. And this 10 inner electrons act as a screen between outer electron and nucleus. Like this. Here outer electrons and nucleus, in between you can see a screen. Okay, here inner electrons act as a screen. More number of inner electrons, that screening effect between outer electron and nucleus is high. Okay, the effect produced by these inner electrons are called screening effect. Out of lithium and sodium, which case screening effect is more? Sodium, because due to more number of inner electrons. Due to this screening effect, the force of attraction between outer electron and nucleus will decrease. Okay, due to this screening effect by inner electrons, due to the screening effect produced by inner electrons, due to this effect, the force of attraction between outer electron and nucleus will decrease. So the outer electron can easily remove from the atom. So what about the ionization value? Ionization value will decrease. Clear? So more the number of inner electron, screening effect will increase, force of attraction between outer electron and nucleus will decrease, then ionization energy also will decrease. So can you give a connection between shielding effect or screening effect with the ionization energy? How it is related? The screening effect is inversely proportional to value of ionization energy or ionization potential. Okay, ionization energy or ionization potential. With more screening effect, ionization energy will decrease. What about lithium? Only two inner electrons. So screening effect is less. If screening effect less, what about the attraction between outer electron and nucleus? More. If more attraction, outer electron is difficult to remove from the atom. So ionization value will increase. Okay. So number of inner electron is less, screening effect also less, but the value of ionization potential is high. So from these two examples, it is very clear. Depends on screening effect, the value of ionization energy will change. The next factor affecting value of ionization potential is half filled and completely filled configuration. To understand this factor, first we should know Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. Hund's rule can easily understand from one example, nitrogen. We can easily understand this rule from example nitrogen. Nitrogen atom number 7. 1s2, 2s2, 2p3 is the electronic configuration, substitute electronic configuration. 1s accommodate maximum 2 electrons. So we can represent by using a box, accommodate 2 electrons. Okay, and 1 electron rotating clockwise, so positive spin. Second one anti-clockwise, negative spin. Okay, then 2s2, 1, 2 electrons, this indicate 2 electrons. 2p3, p can accommodate maximum 6 electrons, so 3 orbital. First orbital is called px, py, pz, this is 2s 1s. Then we can arrange electron like this. 1, 2p3, 3 electron, 2, 1. Okay, And the same electronic configuration we can represent one more way, like this: 1s, 2, 1s an oxygen, 2 electron, 2s, 2, but p orbital a slight change, px, py, pz. px1, instead of writing 2 electron, write 1 electron first. Second, there are 3 electrons. Second, py. Third, pz. Okay, so out of these 2, this configuration is correct. According to Hund's rule, the second configuration is correct. Why second configuration is correct? Because completely half-filled configuration. The completely half-filled configuration is extra stable. Okay, completely half-filled configuration is extra stable. So element always will try to fill like this. This is not completely half-filled. Here it is paired and one is half-filled and here empty. Okay, but this configuration is very important because due to the completely half-filled configuration, the element become extra stable. So element always will try to achieve this configuration. And one more thing, 1s and 2s is completely filled. So completely filled, completely half filled. So both the configurations are very stable. Okay. Then how it connected with the ionization energy? Already I said this configuration is highly stable. So we cannot remove electron easily from this configuration. Removal of electron from nitrogen is difficult. Why? Due to the stable configuration. So what about the ionization energy? Ionization energy will high. Okay, take oxygen. What is oxygen? Atomic number 8. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Okay, and 2p4. Okay, and this configuration is wrong according to Hund's rule. First half filled, then pairing. Okay, so how we can fill it? So this configuration is wrong. How we can fill this one? 1, 2, 3, then 4. But ionization energy of oxygen is less than nitrogen. Why? Because this is not completely half filled. So compared to nitrogen, stability of oxygen is less. So from a less stable configuration, removal of electron is easy. But nitrogen is stable, so removal of electron is difficult. So please tell, what about the ionization energy of oxygen and nitrogen? Ionization energy of oxygen is less than ionization energy of nitrogen. Why ionization energy of nitrogen is high? Because due to stable half-filled configuration, removal of electron become difficult. But in oxygen, configuration is not stable, unstable, so removal of electron is easy. Okay.